For the first time in 4 weeks, Allied Meat Importers was officially open for business, but with pickets hoping to persuade customers not to go in. That was largely successful, but one order was placed and later filled as the managers moved the meat themselves. Although that broke with traditions of union-only labour, which have lasted for more than 50 years in Smithfield, there was no attempt to stop it, the union wishing to play down the dispute, particularly with an election just 2 days away.
Anything changes in the market, it'll change through joint discussion and change by conviction of the two parties, not by imposition. That's always been my position.
And you'll carry on talking?
Yes, I will, of course. Yeah.
But the union are still insisting that their nominee should be given a work trial at AMI, yet the firm still demand their right to choose just who they employ.
All that is required is for Mr. Todd to accept the fact that there is no 51-year-old ruling that says we can't have choice. We have signed statements from his union at the highest level that says we have a choice. Now, unless Mr. Todd is prepared to go on television, take the agreements and tear them up and say these agreements are not worth the paper they're written on, as his officer on spot has already done, then there can be no progress.
So while compromise is one thing both sides seem to reject, the other traders are trying to do business as normal, but business which is already suffering from a drop in custom. While they support AMI's stand against the union's restrictive practices in theory, giving in has become as traditional as the practices themselves. Yet if the proposed multi-million pound redevelopment of the market is to go ahead, those practices will have to be changed. But once again, the seemingly inevitable confrontation has now been postponed. Marcus Powell for Thames News.